In DRAM, we also have a transistor that is activated by the word line and that connects the cell to the bit line. But we said that's the only transistor we have. The cell is made out of a simple capacitor here. So the idea is that to write to this cell, we will activate the word line. We put, let's say, a 1 into the bit line. This transistor connects the capacitor to the bit line. Now what happens is R1 effectively charges this capacitor. Once we deactivate the word line, the capacitor retains the value that corresponds to a 1. If we want to write a 0, we activate the word line. The capacitor is now connected to the bit line that is connected to a 0 voltage, and we empty this capacitor into the bit line. Thus, now our capacitor becomes a 0 value. Now when we disconnect the word line, the capacitor has nothing in it, so it retains the value of 0. So as you can see, the bit is really stored in this capacitor. When it's charged, we are storing a 1. When it's not charged, we are storing a 0. So what's the problem here? Well, the problem is that this transistor is not a perfect switch. It's a little bit leaky. Here it's not a problem, because if it's a little bit leaky, these two are strong enough to retain the voltage at, you know, let's say 1 and 0, or 0 and 1, while these are not trying to defeat them. But here, our capacitor is slowly leaking into the bit line and eventually gets empty. So one problem with DRAM is that it will lose this bit over time, and that means that periodically we have to actually read out this bit, figure out what it was, and write it back in at full voltage so that it can again leak for a while before it gets lost. Another problem with DRAM that you don't have with SRAM is that once we open the word line, the capacitor drains into the bit line. We can sense what the value was, but the capacitor is no longer fully charged. This is called destructive read. When you read a DRAM cell, you have to write it back in. It loses the value as it gets read. So this is what is usually called a 6T cell, or 6 transistor cell. There are 2 transistors that are therefore connecting to the cell, and there are 4 transistors in the cell itself, because each of the inverters has 2 transistors. This is, of course, a 1T cell. Now, the area occupied by an SRAM cell obviously is the area occupied by about 6 transistors. The area of the DRAM cell, it looks like it's the area of 1 transistor and the area of a capacitor. The bigger this capacitor, the longer it can retain something that corresponds to a 1 or a 0 before it gets lost. So we want this capacitor to be big. A capacitor can be viewed as 2 metal plates placed very close to each other. The bigger the area of the plates, the bigger the capacitance of the capacitor. It can keep more charge. So it looks like, to make a good DRAM cell, we will have to make a big cell, because this capacitor will need a lot of metal area to build large plates. But this is not how we build this capacitor. The transistor and the capacitor itself are actually built as a single transistor in a technology that is called trench cell. So this end of this transistor is simply buried deeply into the silicon substrate when we manufacture transistors. So really the capacitor is kind of buried under the transistor. So we really get the area of the transistor itself and not much around it. You can see also that the DRAM cell can be smaller because it doesn't need this second bit line. We just need 1, so that also makes it slightly smaller. We don't need as much wiring there.